Hi, my name is Helena. We're back again with Alex and Eber from the story of Friend or Foe. Let's talk a little bit more about episode 5.
So here in episode 5, amongst all the commotion, the king is still in his quarters. He's going crazier and crazier every day. He's starting to think maybe a foe is a friend. And during all this, a stranger arrives on a white horse, a female, very beautiful. And everyone is hesitant to let her in at first, but she wants to speak to the king. They all have to go on a roundabout table, the king and his two knights, and make a very big decision leading up into this.
So, as far as the management concepts for this episode, it's one of the most in-depth, I would say. This details three decision-making models, being classical, bounded rationality, and the retrospective decision. As far as that, and it goes into David, which he does a classical decision-making process, which it's 7 steps. The first one being identifying the problem, developing objectives and weighing its criteria, generating alternatives, analyzing alternatives, selecting an alternative, implementing that alternative, and then monitoring and evaluating his decision. So with the character Lewis, he does the bounded rationality model, which is satisficing, which means pretty much the very first thing that popped into his head is the decision that he made. He didn't outweigh any of the consequences or any other ideas, pretty much. He did it very quickly, irrationally, and that's pretty much it with that one. As far as the king, he did the retrospective decision model making, which it's pretty much he knew he made a bad decision, and he tries to rationalize it, not really knowing like how it affected the kingdom overall.